A Hanford scientist is helping clean up the contaminated land around Japan's damaged nuclear plants. Yasuo Onishi from the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory at Hanford was asked for his advice on cleanup plans by Japan's prime minister. He's worked on the problem before, 25 years ago at Chernobyl. Onishi says Japan's radioactive cleanup will take time, but the country is moving forward.
A very unfortunate event, but it could be a catalyst, you know, to come up much, you know, stronger nation from energy and then also environmental point of view.
Mr. Onishi says some areas of Japan may never be suitable for people, but they can be used for energy alternatives like solar panel farms.
Tropical Storm Rok is bringing torrential rain to the Pacific side of western and central Japan. It could trigger more damage to areas battered by rains earlier this month. The Meteorological Agency says the storm is moving south over the sea about 220 kilometers east-southeast of the city of Naha in Okinawa Prefecture. The storm is packing winds of more than 80 kilometers per hour at its center. It's causing torrential rain in western and central Japan. Three lakes caused by landslides earlier this month are threatening to overflow. More than 36,000 people are evacuating the affected areas. Nuclear negotiators from North and South Korea are scheduled to meet for talks in Beijing next week. Attentions are focused on what the North will say about its uranium enrichment program. South Korea's foreign ministry says its chief delegate to the six-party nuclear talks, Win Sung-lok, is likely to meet his North Korean counterpart, Ri Yong-ho, next Wednesday. The two sides met in late July on the Indonesian island of Bali, but failed to narrow their differences over the North's enrichment program. At the time, South Korea said the program violates a UN Security Council resolution and demanded that it be halted immediately. But North Korea replied it is only seeking the peaceful use of nuclear energy, a position it reiterated a week later during bilateral talks with the United States in New York.